The arts of the etheria. The arts of the etheria. The etheria.
Today I got round to naming various files for the files on my computer. I save various images off the internet, and this was one of them. So you have the Griffin Masonry cord here from the Ripon Cathedral in England. Now this was the alleged inspiration, as it says here, for the Griffin in Lewis Carroll's Alice's Adventures in Wonderland. Now I've been told by an occultist first up, now they visualize the griffin. It is an elemental, I've been told. I also suspect that that cherubim shapeshift into the griffin form also. But, you know, this is interdimensional stuff, and I'm not sure where you draw the line at times between the griffin and the elemental, but nonetheless, interdimensional creatures. So I thought, for a moment, I'll look at Alice in Wonderland for a moment. So I'm not really that familiar with the story of Alice in Wonderland. So I just looked it up, and basically, of course, you have the rabbit hole and Alice goes down the rabbit hole. Now that would be a crossing of dimensions, if you will, surely. And as you cross the dimension, you go down the rabbit hole, and we can see various images of the rabbit hole here. And within the imagery for Alice in Wonderland, there's plenty of checkered floors and all the rest of it. And then they have looking, I think their next novel by Lewis Carroll was Through the Looking Glass. But anyway, so we're talking about an interdimensional scene, and this came as no surprise. And of course, within that interdimensional scene, we would have the griffin there. The next thing that came to my mind was that of Alice, and I thought of my list, and I didn't recall with this list that I'm showing you right now as to whether Alice was on there or not. And looking through it, I found that she wasn't, so she has now been added to this list. So this list includes characters, if you will, whether you want to think of them as alive or completely fictional characters, that they lived either all or part of their childhood without their biological father. And basically this theme just goes through and through and through and through these stories throughout time. And this particular aspect of all of these stories and accounts will have something to do with our soul's path. But among other things, Lewis Carroll was the pen name for Charles Lutwidge Dodgson, and his life carried through from the 27th of January 1832 to the 14th of January in 1898. So his pen name was Lewis Carroll. Now Lewis would be a very Masonic name in itself, quite interesting, but I can't find anything that definitely sort of ties him to Freemasonry, but we'll just have a look at a few things. So he was an English writer, a mathematician, a logician, and an Anglican deacon and a photographer. And his most famous writing was Alice's Adventures in Wonderland and Looking Through the Looking Glass, and the poem Jabberwocky and the Hunting of the Snark, and bits and pieces. So he was into photography. Now this photograph here is of Alice Liddell, and it was taken by Lewis Carroll in 1858. And quite interesting to see the garment there and how it's lowered, particularly around the left breast area there. And there's also a sexual side to that. And there are plenty of allegations regarding Lewis Carroll and potential ties to pedophilia, and perhaps even the notion of trying to marry an 11-year-old. And this goes on, it's an investigation people can look at themselves. Here is yet another portrait by Lewis Carroll of Beatrice Hatch. And of course you can see the nudity right there. Just with the grave of Lewis Carroll for a moment, you can see the three steps there with the cross atop it. Now the three steps would be a highly Masonic form, although it, you know, I'm just saying that. That'll do it for the moment. I'll leave it at this.